Hey, what's up, everybody? Spaz here. I'm going to show you a quick tutorial. Well, it's not going to be so quick because I'm going to go into detail. But I'm going to show you a tutorial on comms and NAS using the Huey and DCS, all right? First thing we're going to cover, just generally how to get to a base, all right? So you pull up your map. We're going to practice going to Lucchini right here because it's a perfect example where I can show VOR and using your ADF signals, okay? Now your ADF signals, which is what I'm going to cover initially, you got an outer and an inner NDB, okay? And depending on which runway you pick, it's going to depend on which one of these you dial in. Alright, doesn't matter outer or inner, all that it is you got an imaginary line coming off each runway, okay? Runway 31, you're going to approach from here, so this outer and inner NDB is going to be on line with that. The inner is going to be closer, the outer NDB will be further out, and all that's going to do is take you to that non-directional beacon, and then from there you can basically see the airport and fly a visual approach. Or if it's crappy weather, you can't see low visibility, you would plug in your ILS number into your COMNAV panel and fly your ILS approach from there, which I'll do that while we're en route. Main thing is, how do we get our Hueys to the bases that we want to get to? ADF, you plug in any number here. Any one of these four numbers will get you to this base. Okay? You go to another base. Doesn't have it, so you can't use ADF to get to Kutasi. But it's got a VOR. So you can get there. Alright. Kolke, you've only got NDBs for runway 9. So you plug in either one of these numbers, and your ADF needle will point to this base and line you up for an ILS approach, plugging that into your COMNAV for runway 9. Alright, no VOR there, so can't use VOR for that base. Some bases that don't have any navigation at all, the best thing that you can do is hopefully you can see the base and you on your map when you pull up your F10 map. Take you out your ruler. All right, right click you, right click where you want to go, and that's going to give you a basic distance and heading right there at the top of your screen. So you would fly a heading of 346 degrees and try not to deviate from that course, and you would just have to hope and pray that you came across that base. That's the only way you can get to bases that don't have anything. As far as navigating to FARPs, if you're trying to get to a FARP, the only way you're going to navigate to a FARP is using FM homing, which would be this panel right here. And the server owner would have to set up a couple of ground troops, and he would have to tell you in the system message, hey, for FARP such and such, troops are broadcasting such and such channel. You would dial in that frequency that the troops are broadcasting off of right in here, and then you would set it to home, and this vertical needle right here would basically steer you to that signal that you're homing in on. Alright, but we don't have that capability right now. So how do I set up my ADF to get me to Lucchini? Alright, let's shoot for runway 31. We're going to take the inner NDB, or outer NDB, rather, because I want to shoot a longer approach, all right? So that's 211.0. Go to your ADF panel, right-click once here, turn that bad boy on, and then we'll just scroll up to 211. See your signal strength go up, and you'll hear Morse code. That means you're locked on. All right, some of these frequencies are very close together. So, see, like, there's another signal right there. But that's a little bit weaker. That looks like more of a 209. See what our ADF needle points at. And also, you need to make sure that this is set up correctly, because that when you start out, it might not always be zeroed out correctly, and I intentionally moved this to show that, and you can actually have it set. You want to see half a circle and half of the plus, and you want to be able to see half of them just like that, all right? But you need to double check it off your standby compass to make sure that it's not 180 out, which it is. So we're facing 300 approximately, so we know that this is 180 out. So we need to flip this around. And you'll get it in the ballpark, and then zero these two out, dead center, where you can see half of both. All right, now this is going to give you a good accurate heading. All right, so this is saying course 60 approximately should take us to Lucchini. Let's double check. And that is the outer NDB, which would be approximately here. And that could be, that should be in the ballpark of where that is. Course is 60. All right. And I'm just double checking this other one. Yeah, see, that wants to take us northwest. We know that that's not it. All right. So now we're locked in with our ADF. We know that that's going to take us to our outer NDB for runway 31, which will be approximately over here. All right. So you'll be able to see the base, but if you wanted to shoot an ILS approach, how would you do that? All right. Well, this will get you over the marker beacon, and then you're going to shoot an ILS approach from there. You'll take this number for this runway, because we're lining up on runway 31. ILS is 108.90. We'll come to our COMNAV panel, or NAVCOM, which basically this is your VOR slash ILS panel, either or. You can plug in a VOR number here, and that'll make your VOR needle, which is this this two-wing indicator, that'll make that point at whatever VOR station you plug in here, or you can use this for your ILS. All right, so that was 108.90 for the runway that we want. All right, plug that in, and then we'll right-click it once to turn on. And you see the only thing that moved was your glide slope, okay? And this is your left-right course deviation, and then it's telling me I need to turn right. Your glide slope flag is still up, saying that you haven't picked up the elevation signal. And once we get in line with this runway 31 that we have dialed in, this ILS right here, runway 3031, then this will become completely active. All right, and we're going to turn, okay, this is all the way up. You need to make sure that this is turned up from off. If this is off, you won't get your light, you won't get your tone when you fly over your NDB beacon, okay? So we'll turn that up. All right, now we're all set to fly our approach. And by the way, this switch right here doesn't do anything. All it does is slave your ADF needle to whatever your VOR is pointing at. So if I had a VOR channel dialed in on my NAVCOM and I didn't want to watch my ADF pointing off in wherever, just so you could quickly glance and not worry about it, you would just click VOR and it would make them both point at whatever VOR station you have plugged in here. But right now we don't have a VOR station plugged in. That's why this isn't going to move. We've got a ILS station plugged in, so it's only going to utilize this. All right, so we're all set up ADF. Rudderhead spooled up. And taking off. Thank you. and you'll just keep an eye on your ADF needle. It's not going to give you a range, so you won't know until you're there. You'll hear your marker beacon making noise, all right? And you see our glide slope antenna? Let's see. That flag has disappeared, and now we have a horizontal indicator. So we know we're close, and actually we're just now, right over the nose is the NDB station. And then you get a tone, there's your light. So now we know we need to turn left, course 301. That's approximately course 301, and hey look, there's a runway. Alright. So at this point, the ADF is pointing behind you, and that's because you flew over that NDB station. And what you want to do is you're going to fly the runway heading that we got off of our kneeboard, which was 301, and you'll be looking at your glide slope, which is telling me I need to go down and left. And that glide slope's only going to work if you've got an ILS number plugged into your COM-NAV panel down there. Alright, we're passing over the inner NDB station. That's what that second tone is for. Letting us know we're halfway there to the runway. And I'm still really a little bit too high. I'm going to go ahead and almost in an auto here. Some altitude. And looking at your glide slope, you want to try to make those needles line up in a crosshair over that circle. And anything in that circle is going to put you right onto the runway. And then just follow it down. Have it. That's how you use your ADF and ILS. Alright. And now I'm going to fly off of here, extend a little bit, and show you guys how to use your VOR. And like I, you don't have to use ILS. It's just something that it's good to know. Good to use if you got bad weather, low visibility, which is pretty rare in DCS, but alright. So we're gonna turn our ADF off. You'll see your needle goes back to neutral. And we're gonna, because you have to plug in your VOR into this channel right here in this panel. So let's look up. Our VOR is 113.7. 13.7. And you see, your VOR needle is now pointing at the VOR station. And you can click that to make them both point at it. And they'll both track it. Doesn't matter. It's, that preference is pretty much up to you, okay? And that's off. Okay, now you'll see when you're using VOR, you get a course deviation marker, but your glide slope won't do anything. And this course deviation is manually set according to this knob. Okay, you don't have to do anything with this unless you want to fly a straighter path to the base. Okay, all you got to do is point this needle in front of you right here. And you'll get there. But Hueys have a tendency to crab. And so by setting that, you can alleviate some of that, especially if it's really far away. Alright, and now we're tracking straight there. And so we're basically heading roughly north. So if you set this to zero, or due north, and your course deviation indicator is going to be right on. And let's say you were a lot further away than you are, and you start to drift off course. Now our needle's still pointing in front of us, but you're kind of, see how we're drifting off of our initially set path? And that course deviation path is telling you you're drifting off to the right. And so that'll keep you on a perfectly straight path to the target and eliminate you basically flying half a circle. See the course deviation indicator coming back to the center. Let me know I'm back on my set desired heading to this VOR station. Again, you don't have to use that. That's optional. It's completely up to you. This will always point at whatever VOR channel you dial in on this panel. And there's your VOR station right there in the chin bubble. And you'll see your VOR needle flip around as you fly over. And there it goes. Alright, so that covers your using ADF to get to any base via setting it to any NDB signal and using your VOR to get to any base that has that, setting that VOR into your nav comm. Okay, last thing is going to be using the radios in a Huey. And for a lot of people it can be tricky, but I can straighten out a lot of that confusion as well. I'm just going to set it down here so we can discuss that. Alright, communications. You got VHF radio right here. And I'm going to turn this off so we don't hear that beeping. Oh, on a side note, if you don't want to hear all your navigation crap beeping away all the time, right here where it says nav, just flip that off. You should still get your marker tones, but you won't hear the annoying Morse code. Alright, and this is where I'm going to start talking about this panel, because this panel controls what you hear. There's all these switches. One should be channel one here, so VHF. So if I turn one off, I won't hear my VHF radio, etc. 1, 2, 3, 4. Four is not used in a Huey. Interphone would be if I got an actual person over here sitting in this using the in-game ICS to talk back and forth. I turn that off. I don't have to hear his crap anymore. Alright. So this is what you're hearing in your headset to each corresponding radio. And this is what you're going to broadcast on. If you want to talk to tower, you got private, which is just me and co-pilot. Interphone, which is everybody in the aircraft. Channel 1, which is hover over it. Is your VHF right here. 2 is your UHF. 3 is your FM. If you had this set up, you dial in whatever number on your FM radio, hit transmit receive, and you're on channel 3. So now when you pull your communication right here, it's going to say VHF AM radio. Alright. But we want to use UHF. And we want to talk to the tower, Lucchini. But right now they're not going to hear us because we don't have the right number dialed in, and two, you got to turn it on to transmit receive. Okay, and same thing here. If you dialed in the VHF, you would have to right click it one time to turn it on. If you want to use your FM radio, you dial in whatever channel and go to transmit receive. Alright, so for Lucchini, here's your radio frequencies, ATC. Alright, first number is going to be your VHF radio. Second number is going to be your VHF FM or AM. That number is what you would plug into right here. And then this is your UHF number. And I don't think the VHF works at Lucchini, so we're just going to plug in 267. And make sure we're on transmit receive, and we are. Channel 2, which is your UHF. And now, we can talk to Lucchini.
So good luck. Boozy, 1-1. Request startup. Lucchina, Boozy, 1-1. Request startup.
Alright, and if you were using your VHF channel, dial that in, whatever that number is for that particular tower right here in your VHF comm. Switch it over to channel 1, and then you would talk to tower. And that's about it. The only other thing I can think of is for if you want to navigate to a base that doesn't have... I kind of touched on this earlier, but there's another tip I want to give you. A base that doesn't have any VOR or outer or inner NDBs. It's got a TACAN here, but this NTQE doesn't have the TACAN radio installed. So, right-click your aircraft with your ruler. Right-click the base where you want to go. 4 nautical miles at heading of 120. All right, you make sure your horizontal situation indicator is zeroed out and paired up roughly with your standby, and it is. So we want to fly a heading of 120, which is right here, so you can set this bug to 120 and just put that right here on your actual heading and fly that course and just don't deviate from that course any more than you know can help, really. I mean, if it's windy, if you're crabbing, or if you're sliding a little bit, you're gonna be off course. The only thing you can do is keep going back to your map, checking, updating your position. You see yourself drifting off, just draw another line, get your new course, adjust your heading accordingly. Oh, not that knob, this knob. Okay, that's the only way to get to bases that don't have a VOR or an NDB. Alright, once again, NDBs go in your ADF right here. And if you want to use ILS, you plug it in right here. ILS is only going to show, make your glide slope work. Okay. And your VOR channel goes in right here on your NAVCOM. And that's going to make your double-ended needle point. And if you decide to slave the ADF needle to it. Now once you slave this ADF needle, once you pick VOR right here, whatever you got dialed in right here isn't going to show anything, okay? So, just make sure you're in ADF if you want to be tracking with your ADF panel. Pretty straightforward. Doesn't take a whole lot of practice to get it down. But I think I've pretty well covered all the details. If I missed anything or if there's any questions, feel free to leave comments. And I'll be checking it periodically over the next couple of weeks. And hopefully this helps you guys out. And have a good day, and I'll see you online, man.